Article 5, Institutional Affiliation, 28. In order to promote common NRN issues and achieve mutual goals and objectives of the NRNA and NRNA-USA, the board shall formulate policy, develop and maintain a cooperative, collaborative and supportive relationship with all Nepali and Nepal-related associations in the United States and Nepal, and provide an opportunity with the NRNA and NRNA-USA hereby called institutional affiliation, provided that such institutional affiliation satisfies all of the following requirements. It subscribes to the vision, objective and purpose of the NRNA and NRNA-USA bylaws. It is a registered non-profit organization in any state within the United States. With respect to an organization outside of the United States, the following additional requirements must be met. 1. Associations must consent to the state of Tennessee jurisdiction if there is any dispute between associations. 2. Associations' purpose, goal, act, mission, rules shall not be inconsistent with the United States federal law and state law of the respective state. 3. Associations' purpose, goal, act, mission, and rules shall not be inconsistent with the NRNA NRNA-USA certificate of incorporation and bylaws. D. NRNA NRNA-USA affiliation to NRNA-ICC. NRNA-NRNA-USA will function as an entity of NRNA-ICC in the USA and support its objectives, programs by organizing and managing NRNA activities within and under the law of land of the United States of America. 2. NRNA-NRNA-USA will donate some funds it has generated through donation or membership fees in the USA to NRNA-ICC to comply with the ICC bylaws. NRNA-ICC will provide necessary PO, invoice, applicable W-8 receipt, and status of the NRNA-ICC as non-profit documents issued by the government of Nepal accordingly to NRNA-ICC for the compliance purpose and document substantiation for the audit. NRNA-NRNA-USA will make sure it complies with the respected laws of the land of the USA before releasing the fund. 3. NRNA-NRNA-USA shall comply with the constitution, directives, and guidelines of NRNA-ICC to the extent permitted by law of the USA's land. Article 6, National Board of Directors and Officers, 29. There shall be a board of directors and officers, hereinafter referred to as the board, to formulate and implement programs and activities to achieve the objectives of the NRNA. 30. The board shall make policy suggestions to the annual general meeting or special meeting of members. 31. The board shall have the power to form committees and task force as may be deemed necessary and shall determine the functions and the terms of their existence. 32. The board shall take any action or decision required to be taken at the board meeting through email, fax, internet, and conference calls. 33. The board shall have the power to hire administrative staff as deemed necessary and compensate for the person's services. 34. The board shall hold its annual general meeting or to transact the organization work, including but not limited to review the past year program activities and account, recommend policy changes, and consider any other business of the agenda that is allowed by the presiding officers at his or her sole discretion. 35. The National Board shall coordinate and communicate with the U.S. Embassy in Nepal and obtain necessary help from the U.S. Embassy for NRNA members while NRNA members are in Nepal. 36. The officers of the board shall consist following positions: A. President, B. Senior Vice President, C. Vice President, 4. D. Woman Vice President, E. General Secretary, F. Secretary Open, G. Secretary Women, H. Treasurer, I. Joint Treasurer, J. Spokesperson, K. Youth Coordinator, L. Women Coordinator, M. 12 Directors, Board Members, N. Regional Committee Chair, RCC Northeast, Regional Committee Chair, RCC Midwest, Regional Committee Chair, RCC South, Regional Committee Chair, RCC West. 36.1. There shall be 30 elected positions in the board with a maximum of 31 total numbers of positions. Of above positions shall be elected, etc. accept spokesperson by the members of the NRNA and NCC-USA as described in these bylaws. 36.2. The vice president shall have one more departments. The president shall assign the portfolios with the consultation of the executive board and the committees, and the task force shall form under those departments. The departments shall be as follows: Government Liaison and Public Relations Affairs, Senior Vice President by default; Governance, Discipline and Institutional Development and Expansion Affairs, Senior Vice President by default; Women Empowerment, Gender Equality, Human Rights and Children Welfare Affairs, Women Vice President by default; Immigration and Mainstream Integration Affairs; Philanthropy, Disaster Management and Humanitarian Assistance Affairs; Capacity Building and Human Capital, Skill, Knowledge and Innovation Affairs; Commercialization, Investment and Business Relationship Development Affairs; Nepali Language and Literature, Culture, Tradition and Art Affairs; Youth Empowerment, Education and Student Affairs; Resource Development, Nepal House, Tourism and Nepal Promotion Affairs; Public Safety, Environment, Public Health and Road Safety; Community Support and Institutional Relation Affairs; Membership and Policy Procedure Affairs. There are basically A to L number of department. Deleted. The geographical region for the vice presidents from the regions shall be allocated as below. A, B, C, D has been deleted. 37. The national board president, in consultation with the board within the scope and limitations of the provisions of the state laws and these bylaws, may establish, amend or terminate groups, task forces or committees to promote the NRNA and NCC-USA activities, which may include representatives from the associations as well as individuals from the larger Nepali diaspora or NRN within the United States and the respective region. 38. The election of the directors and the officers of the board shall be conducted as stated in these bylaws. 39. The term of the directors and officers of the board shall be 2 years, beginning first weekend of July of the calendar year. No director or officer of the board shall hold the same office for more than 2 consecutive terms. Youth coordinator shall have an age limit of not more than 30 years.